"When you know Brother better," said Shaggy earnestly, "you will be glad he has become one of your loyal subjects. I am just getting acquainted with him myself, and I find much in his character to admire." Leaving the brothers, Ozma and the girls continued their walk. Presently, Betsy exclaimed, "Shaggy's brother can't ever be as happy in Oz as I am. Do you know, Dorothy, I didn't believe any girl could ever have such a good time anywhere as I'm having now."
"I know," answered Dorothy. "I felt that way myself lots of times."
"I wish," continued Betsy dreamily, "that every little girl in the world could live in the Land of Oz, and every little boy, too."
Ozma laughed at this.
"It is quite fortunate for us, Betsy, that your wish cannot be granted," said she, "for all that army of girls and boys would crowd us so that we would have to move away."
"Yes," agreed Betsy, after a little thought, "I guess that's true."
End of chapter 25.
End of Tick Tock of Oz by L. Frank Baum.
The Scarecrow of Oz by L. Frank Baum. Chapter 1. The Great Whirlpool.
"Seems to me," said Cap'n Bill, as he sat beside Trot under the big acacia tree, looking out over the blue ocean, "seems to me, Trot, as how the more we know, the more we find we don't know."
"I can't quite make that out, Cap'n Bill," answered the little girl in a serious voice after a moment's thought, during which her eyes followed those of the old sailor man across the glassy surface of the sea.
"Seems to me that all we learn is just so much gained."
"I know. It looks that way at first sight," said the sailor, nodding his head. "But those as knows the least have a habit of thinking they know all there is to know, while them as knows the most admits what a terrible big world this is. It's the knowing ones that realize one lifetime ain't long enough to get more'n a few dips of the oars of knowledge.